Okay, so we've talked about families and we've talked about children. Do you have any advice for people that are on online dating apps?
Trust but verify. So what dating apps do is dating apps have the one of the reasons they're so popular is because they have literally created an ecosystem that is driven on emotional decision making. You're the swiping left, the swiping right, the matching, all of that stuff, and then you're so eager to get paired that now you're oversharing, right? You're sharing information with a perfect stranger who you've never met, who you all you see is a photo, which could have come from anywhere. And if they're on a VPN, like you don't know that Dan is 5 miles away. Dan could be in, Nigeria or Kazakhstan or wherever, just trying to fish your information because it's part of a social engineering hack to whatever. Whitney Cummings, who's a comedian, has got a great podcast called Good For You. Again, not an ad. But like she was on this dating app called Raya. And so she would always be like, oh no, I want to FaceTime. Like, I want to see your bathroom. Open your medicine cabinet so that I know you're not as crazy as I am. Right. But the more that you can see someone in this kind of a dynamic versus that perfectly curated, false expectation environment is the other thing. And especially for women, like I tell my sisters this all the time. I mean, they're all married and relationships now, but went back when they were dating, I was like, listen, if a guy says we should hang out and you say yes, and he doesn't immediately come up with, great, how about Saturday sushi, 7 o'clock? Meet me there at 6:45. We'll have a drink beforehand. He's not into you. Okay. So like, don't like if you match with someone on a dating app and they don't immediately have a plan to take you out, delete them because all they're going to do is waste your time and build up your expectation. Like a man has a plan. Okay. Other people have other ulterior motives that extend beyond trying to court you.